So this is the beginning of a CNC adventure with the Shapeoko, which I'm pretty pumped about. Unboxing here, everything's nicely organized. The instructions are a little skimpy, but you can get online and find some things. Everything's nicely sorted. You can see that you get up through the boxes, you get all your hardware and your parts, and you can start to begin assembly right away. Here, I put the MDF waste board together with the frames, got all the motors out, started to prep them and get ready. You can see that they're all nicely pre-assembled for you. Start assembling the X-axis right away. The Z-axis here has some interesting pieces to it, an adjustment for tension of the belt. And then there's a little bit of a gap in the instructions on how to assemble these springs, which sort of pre-tension the Z-axis and allow you to put them together. They also kind of left out that you need to mount this on there first before you put it together, and it's sharp, be careful. Managed to cut myself. But you can see I'm gonna leave the blood on there for a badge of honor. Got the X-axis assembled with the Z assembled. Most of that put together and mounted on the top there. This is a nice piece of equipment. It's really well built. I like these aluminum cross members. They're nice and thick. You can tell if you look through the iterations of the first and second versions of the X-Carb that Inventables has been working their way through this, and Carbide 3D has really made a next generation machine. It's very nice. There's a cover for the electronics, which is pretty sweet. That's one concern I had, was getting dust in the electronics, because this shop tends to be dusty, even though I'm always trying to blow it out. So you can see here that I'm starting to assemble the belts on the X-axis, and I'm following the directions on my phone there, which was pretty helpful. The online directions aren't bad. It took me a while to figure out how to use these L-brackets. They connect via a hex head screw. You route it underneath the wheels and pulleys there, and then you push them up between and get them over the main drive pulley. And once you get them tight, then you can pull them tight on the other side, thread the first few threads of the screw in, and then tighten them with the screws. Same thing for the Y-axis, one on each side. It helps if you can get around to the other side of the machine to do this. And here I am, finally testing this out. It should be noted here that the Shapeoko 3 instructions caution you against over-tightening the belt because you could bend the shaft on the motors. I'm not sure how to test for tension. This seems a little tight. I'll probably get back to it later to figure it out.
All right. So that about sums it up. I've assembled the whole Shapeoko, and the only thing left for me to do is square it up and get that computer running so I can test it out.